The Nose by Nikolai Gogol is an 1836 short story, which I highly recommend. It is just wacky, satirical, magically realistic, and funny as all hell, too. And that's being honest. I know that a lot of people kind of tribute comedy, and they'll say, like, oh, this book is hilarious. And then it's like, really? Because then you'll see it as, like, a darker elements to it, but... The Nose by Nikolai Gogol, is divided into three parts, and it starts out with this barber named Ivan, who, wakes up one morning eating breakfast to find a nose in his suit, oddly enough, and then his wife points out that it belongs to one of his customers, a customer named, Assessor Kovalyov, who, also known as Major Kovalyov. And, you know, this is the time in Russian society, right during, I'm going to say, like, probably as early as the 1820s, maybe 1830s, like, serfdom. This was before serfdom was abolished, from what I know of Russian history. And basically, when that happened, before that happened, there were serfs, you know, or I'd say after that happened, there were serfs that were integrated into society that were working their way up, getting kind of silly jobs. Like, there were jobs that didn't really have much meaning, so a lot of them got, like, kind of civic counselors. So that's why you find a lot of Dostoevsky or a lot of Gogol, who kind of have that, have a lot of characters. Like, you know, Dostoevsky's The Double, which I should do pretty soon, because this is very much a inspiration to Dostoevsky's The Double. And there's a, you know, the character I think of Yuichi, I think, in that is, you know, very much a kind of civic counselor type of, I don't want to say BS job, but kind of like a, like, just vying for attention, he's very sycophantic and vying for attention. I get that sense from this. There were strict divisions in class around this time, too. Like, majors and generals and all that. It was a very, Russian society was a very military-based status thing, which I guess you kind of see today, too. You see that in some cultures. Like, there's a strong kind of reverence for the military, almost in, not quite in a tribal way, but definitely in a kind of high esteem when you serve your military term, and there were very much, like, paying positions, too. Like, it wasn't the type of thing where you get, like, a GI bill, and that's about it. It was actually, these were, like, paying positions, too, so they, so yeah, back to the plot is that, Ivan basically wraps up the nose and tries to keep it hanging, is the best way you can deal with such an absurd, ridiculous scenario like this, but he keeps it nice and deposed, or, fighting off all the urge to do a pun, but, yeah, he keeps it, safe and basically kind of plays it by ear for the next, in the next section, they're the same guy that the nose came from, the Major Kovalyov guy, wakes up to find his nose missing, obviously. So this kind of cements the fact that this is happening, this is, like, you know, truly, and he basically grabs this mirror to see his face, and then he's, like, very distraught, and basically throughout this whole part of the novel is a lot of very silly parts, which I thought were just hilarious, honestly, that were, like, the nose starts dressing up like him and taking on his identity and inserting himself into his place, kind of, like, doing the very things that he did as the assessor, the things that he did, the nose were doing, the nose is doing now, and even better than him, and that's making him very upset, clearly, and he's, like, distraught, running around, and throughout this part of the novel, I don't want to give too much away, actually, because I didn't want to make this quite quick to the point one, which is totally not what I'm prone to do, but, yeah, it's basically, there's a lot of different dramatics going along with certain daughters wanting to marry, and this and that, like, I think there's, like, a daughter that wants to marry this, major, to get, like, a better place in society, to kind of leverage her way up, and as such is a lot with Russian novels at the time, too, like, you know, certain things of, like, oh, marry a major, that's the best way of getting into that, financial status. And so, yeah, Russian guy ends up, wakes up back with his nose reattached, and basically the, goes back to getting his, shaved by the same barber, and that's how it ends, and just continues back his old ways, and carries on. And that, I think, going back to the whole thing about feeling very, paranoid about, you know, people taking on certain roles and stuff, again, that, you see that in the double, too, like, the, like, his double kind of doing that, in the same, it's in the shape of the nose, and it's something so ridiculous. This is why I think it's perfect satire, is because, Gogol is able to translate something, a very pressing concern about how inane and irrational it is to fear about one's status or one's certain things like that. It's just like how, you know, silly it is in the end of the day, if like somebody's to the point where that you, this is, that's why magic realism is such like a interesting device, is because you're able to communicate these things with, throughout the kind of ridiculous, like a thing that, you know, something in, you know, as dumb as maybe a talking fox or a talking goat or something, and, you know, Mikhail Bulgakov's, or was it Bulgakov's, you know, The Master and the Margarita, you know, like that, too. It's like a talking cat with a cigar, and you know, like, things that are so, you know, seemingly absurd, but they play into something, you know, where it's, like, not that different from what you kind of see in real life. So, that is my take on the nose. Thank you for watching. Bye.